everybody. I got a nice blues boogie I'm going to show you today. It's a boogie that you can put into anywhere that you're doing a standard shuffle. Anywhere you're doing this thing, you can lay that boogie that I'm going to show you down in the same spot. So let's not waste some more time. We'll zoom in on the neck and get started with this idea. All right, so we're going to be playing this 12-bar boogie idea in the key of A, covering a typical 12-bar blues, because it's so popular, it's easy to apply this with that format. And what we're going to be starting on, of course, is the tonic chord, which is the A7. We're going to hit open A twice, move up to the C natural, then the C sharp on that fifth string. Then we're going to head over to the E on the fourth string, play that twice, up to the F sharp, back to the E, and that's all taking place on the fourth string. That brings us to the end of the first measure. Then on the second measure for this phrase, we're going to head up to a higher octave of A on the second fret of the fourth string. Head over to an F sharp, grab a C sharp, move over to an E on the fourth string, play that twice, and then up to the F sharp and take it back to the E. So the second measure riff goes like this. First measure again, second measure, put them two of them together. All right, and we're going to take that riff and just dump it over to this harmony in the outline of a D7 chord, because that's our 4 chord in the key of A if we're doing a blues in A. So let's take a look how it operates in the D chord. We're going to hit the open 4th string D twice, move up to an F natural, F sharp, so we get our minor 3rd major 3rd there. We're going to grab an A and a B and take it back to the A on the 3rd string. Really straightforward, very similar to what we did on the A chord, but you know, shot over the next two strings down towards the floor of the guitar, you know, from the guitar neck. And then we're going to head over to the high D, play that two times, grab a B, grab an F sharp on the fourth and third strings there. Then we're going to have the A come in two times, the B, and back to the A. So one more time, second measure on the D chord takes us up to the high second string, third fret, D octave there, B on the third string, fourth fret, F sharp on the fourth string, fourth fret, back to the A twice, B, A, that's second and fourth frets of the third string. Put the two of them together and you get this. A little bit faster. Really nice sound, real nice boogie. Now we have the format for the A chord, we have the format for the D chord. Let's do the ending of the 12-bar blues to wrap all this up. Because the ending just shoots through the E and the D and the A and the E again on one measure apiece, we have to play this as only half of the riff. So we're going to start on the E, play the E open two times, move up to the G sharp, grab the B two times, C sharp, back to the B. That's just taking care of that stuff on the sixth and fifth strings. But it's the same riff we've been doing all along on the A chord, on the D chord, it's the same ideas. In fact, speaking of the D chord, here it is again, it's going to show up on the next measure. Then we're going to head back to the tonic chord of A. And then we're going to head back to that 5 chord of E to wrap things up in the 12th measure. Okay, here's the whole turnaround running through measures 9, 10, 11, and 12. So that brings us to the end of the 12-bar blues. I'm just going to show you one more bonus idea yet, and it takes place on either the tonic chord of A, or you could do it also on the 4 chord of D. And all it is in the second measure. I'm going to demonstrate this on the A chord. In the second measure, nothing to do with the first measure. The first measure is going to be the same. But the second measure, as it rolls in, we're going to have the same start. But then, on that turnaround phrase at the end there, we're going to do a little bit of a pull-off idea, hammer-on pull-off idea, take us over to the C sharp to wrap up the measure. So, it's a little bit of fancy ending there. You can tell what I'm doing there. I'm just sort of snapping off from that F sharp to the E, bringing in a C sharp now for the ending note. Before, we were on the A chord, we were landing on the E, so we were doing it like this. But we're just jazzing it up a bit now, doing it with a pull-off, taking us to the C sharp. So now we've got a little bit different phrase there. All right, just a bonus idea that you can toss in when you get bored of playing all the other stuff. There you go, though. That's it. That's the nice, fast boogie that you can add in over top of any time you're doing the standard shuffle.
The Blues Guitar Styles ebook is a masterclass course covering a huge amount of information on the blues style. With 8, 12, and 16 bar blues progressions, classic blues styles, plus all the important chord patterns. There's over 50 pages of information, including sections on blues techniques like slide, alternate tuning, and bending. This ebook has everything the guitar player needs for a solid foundation in blues guitar, including 27 MP3 audio tracks for easy at-home study. Blues Guitar Styles is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com.
I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.